Hey guys, I'm LB. Last episode, we read some of the stuff in this terminal, and yeah. We also ascended the elevator last episode, and looks like there's interesting stuff to be explored. Oops, come on, let me step up this. Huh. Guess this is just eye candy? A. What happens if we go outside? Ah, I bet that's the tower that we're not supposed to ascend. Right. Well, we haven't done all the puzzles in here, so let's go back down. So we did two last time, let's do three. Alright, AI feedback. We keep discussing what an artificial intelligence would mean to us and how it would change our understanding of the world. That's a great topic, and I think we've covered it extensively. What we've barely mentioned, though, is the other side of the coin. I mean, our lives would still be what they were before, AI or no AI. The question I think we should discuss, even if it's all completely hypothetical, is the perspective of the artificial intelligence itself. What would it be like to be that creature, to suddenly come into being, created by others as an experiment? To have all the information about yourself, to know exactly how you function. What would you think about the world? Would you see meaning? Beauty? How would you judge humanity? Where would you see yourself fitting into the grand scheme of things? I think we should try to put ourselves into the shoes of such a being. Dear Alexandra, thank you for your feedback, but this is a philosophy course, not science fiction. And that's why I almost gave up on my studies. That is a horrible reply to give to somebody! This is a philosophy course, not a science fiction course? That's terrible! How could you say that to someone? That's like... If you say that, that means you believe that we will never have AI. These are real philosophical questions that need to be considered. These are not things with simple answers, people. Whatever. Team leads. We're blessed to have so many people contributing to this project, but we've got to make sure everyone is on the same page. Please refer to the following people when blah. Alexandra Drinan, Project Lead AI Module. Nadja Sarabhai, Institute Coordinator. Rob McLean, EL Software. Trevor Donovan, EL Hardware. George Jameson, Generation Module. Alan Jameson, Scenario Module. Rob Rakowski, Simulation Module. Radhia Brickmont, blah. Aurora Calvin, Link Hardware. Omar Garib, Link Software. Blah Lenin, Maintenance Module. J.E. Harrison, Diagnostic Blah. Frank Ngatai, Memory Module. Jared V. Shimlev, File Sys Blah. Sun Wei Ying, Talos Unit, formerly Soma. Soma, that's another game that I'm never going to play. And I mean that for real. It's not my type of game. If it wasn't a horror game and there weren't stupid horror monsters in it to avoid, I would totally play that game, but they just kind of put the monsters in there for no reason. Anyway, though not directly part of her project, the archive team is sharing both physical and digital space with us. If there are any technical issues to resolve, please contact their project lead, Arkady Chernysky. Don't worry, he's nice, even if you can't pronounce his name properly. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I butchered every one of those names. Stration of Stagira was a Greek materialist philosopher associated with the Peripatetic school. An admirer of Aristotle, he was a proponent of empiricism and a fierce critic of philosophy that placed belief before observable truth. Though unpopular with many of his peers for his often acerbic personal manner, his commentaries on Aristotle were considered an important work. Much of his writing was lost in the destruction of the Library of Alexandria. Interesting. Okay, where do we want to go first? How about here? Oops. It's clear I'm not the first to walk this path. In fact, the whole thing seems to have been consciously designed, but by the voice in the sky or some other force. Yeah, it seems like it's like from supposedly another version of me or something is leaving these QR codes around, but I don't know. Well, I think I actually saw the glitch there for a moment. Locked me up, swallowed the key. Oh, okay, locked doors. That's just interesting. I'm loving the Fizzler puzzles, though. Interesting. Ah, here's the key. Alright, now what? Can't do anything over there yet, so let's do that. Ah, here's our second, disruptor. Jammer. I'm called jammers, but I keep calling them disruptors. I've been watching Vertical Electric play too much Axiom Verge, it seems. Oh, right. Wait, did I actually jam it properly? Yeah, okay. There we go. Oh, look at this, a ladder. Alright, that's done. Let's cross out on all the signs. Let's go over here. Stashed for later. Okay, so this is how we're gonna leave. Interesting. It's already got one of them jammed for us. Oop, that's not good. Oh, so we need a key, but where would said key be? Interesting. Startled me. Ah, here's the key. Now, where would we want to use this? Well, probably here, for starters, right? I like how they can't get me through the bars, that's nice. Right, we want to block those two things. How about we do that? There we go. That should make things pretty simple, right? Yep. Alright then, how about the other side? Okay, two stars. I'm still not sure about those, I think I have to play the demo. I can access the demo from the main game, which is nice. Don't have to exit the game or anything weird like that. An escalating problem. Wait, what? Seek counsel? What does that do? I spent much time waiting for the designer to take my hand until I realized that he had been guiding me all along. I realized that it isn't for me to seek his help, it is for me to help myself. Interesting.
Here, those who are worthy may seek the counsel of my blessed messengers. But their wisdom shall not be given easily, for your accomplishments must be your own.
What does that even mean? Is that like giving me a hint or something? Huh. Oh! Didn't even see that. What's over here? Why? Huh. Why would I want... Does that robot run up against this? Oh wait, that's in the way! What happens if I take this out of the way and let the robot go up there? Looks like he'll go up those stairs, maybe. Okay. That seems to have worked, right? Oh, I have a window. Well, that's how I'm getting this guy through then. Is there another... Okay, so this is a way back. Oops, what's up here? Oh, this is a big area. Oh, there's keys as well? Wow, this is a big area. Was not expecting that. Is this guy in a loop? I guess they're just on a loop. But I need... right... something like this, right? This isn't gonna work, right? Wait, I can? How does... Okay, I'll take it, but that I would have never... I did not expect that to work. I was just... Wow, okay. As soon as I get in range. It was disabled at the start of the level. Like there'd be two jammers, because then that would be trivial to get the key. Making very much sense to me right now. Okay, well, let's see what this thing does.
The counsel of my blessed messengers must be earned.
Autoresponder. Interesting. Wait, that has my name on it. Yeah, it says LB. Over there is still active. this window. Wait a minute. Can I get that guy to join in on the fun?
My child, there is no shame in seeking another path. Leave this mystery for another day.
Yeah, I know it's getting close to the end of the episode, but... Oh! How was I supposed to know he would path up here? That makes a lot of sense. Well... Okay then. Well guys, that's it for this episode. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one. As always, if you hate the sound of my voice, leave a dislike, it's up to you, and goodbye.